Please introduce yourself to all of our readers.
Hi, my name is Krissy Downing. I'm a surrealist artist. Moved to Seattle about a year ago and just trying to get my feet wet in the art community here in Seattle.
Where were you before this?
I lived in Washington, D.C. I grew up in Seattle, but I lived in D.C. for 10 years and I became an artist while I was out there.
Cool. Were you doing artwork in D.C.?
I was trying to. The art community in D.C. wasn't quite as embracing.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they were a lot more competitive. I tell people that, the art scene in D.C., they were kind of like, oh, you have amazing art skills. I don't want to have anything to do with you because you'll steal my thunder. Whereas here, it's like, oh, you have amazing art and I want to put my art next to your art. So I'm like, come join me.
Does it feel like it's more of a family here?
It does. It really does. I feel like I have all these brothers and sisters that all have the same interest as me. Yeah.
Very nice. So how long have you been working?
I've been a professional artist for about 2 years now.
Nice.
Yeah, I quit my full-time job back in D.C. and gave it a try out there and then started over when I came out here a year ago.
So tell me a little bit about this piece, the large piece that's behind you.
This is called Unripened Perspective.
Uh-huh.
And it's basically, these are futuristic beings that are sort of hyper-evolved, evolved way into the future.
Oh, very nice.
The thing that kind of links them to the world that we know is the trees. It's, if you look at it, it's basically the only thing that's kind of exemplary of the world that we're aware of or that we know. So it kind of links them to their ancestry or their outlook on life. So.
Would you consider yourself a surrealist?
Yes.
Nice. Kind of a pop surrealist or more in the classic vein, say like Dali or André Breton or something like that?
When I first started creating artwork, I didn't label myself, and other people labeled me as a pop surrealist, and then I realized I don't really reference pop culture very much in my work, so I'm not sure that I would call myself a pop surrealist.
Almost has a more classical sort of set of references.
Yeah. I had also never heard of Salvador Dali until people started saying, you must get all your inspiration from Salvador Dali.
Oh, nice, nice.
I looked him up.
Did he end up having any influence after that?
I like his animations. I like his moving pictures that he's done with Disney.
Oh, yeah.
Some of his weirder stuff that he did later in his career.
Was that one ever released?
You can find it on YouTube now.
Nice, very nice.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
So tell me, what kind of projects do you have in the burner right now?
I'm going to Sasquatch Festival to be a live painter with a bunch of stinky artists.
Nice, nice.
A bunch of tents. So that will be fun. That'll be a new experience for me.
Very cool. Very cool. Do you have a website?
I do. It's krissydowning.com. KRISSY Downing.
Nice. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Krissy Downing, and I'm a Pacific Northwest artist.
Thank you very much.